Hello everyone, this is David Moffat from Axe Annex Tabletop Gaming, and today I have a little hobby time video for you. This is a video where I'm not necessarily 100% confident on the process that I'm doing. I'm more just playing around and trying to figure it out as I go along. If you have any comments or suggestions, please just, you know, write them up down below where such things are appropriate. In this video, I'm going to tackle my character model I got from Angel Barracks, as well as one of the other ones I had input on. The Mont Hault 6mm figure, as well as Brigette, who is based on the Androgyne. Is it Androgyne? Androgyne. Gynoid? Gynoid. Which is based on a Gynoid. You know, like the Mass Effect or Metropolis kind of female robot, which I think looks pretty cool. I'm pairing them together as a team of specialists, HQ, for various 6mm games. I haven't settled on which one yet, but in any case, I wanted to get him painted up and ready to put on the tabletop. So here we go! Well, here is Mont Hault and Brigette from CP Models. This one is Mont Hault, this one is Brigette. It's super hard to see right now because they're in white primer. Let's see if we can tell them apart once we put on a bit of paint. Let's do some metallic first, see what happens. I'm going to apply some Rejo Chrome Model Air all over the gynoid, and a bits and pieces on the Mont Hault. This chrome is a beauty. He's got a sword on this side. Guard. I think that's where his glasses are. Oh, I did a bad job on the priming originally. Just blocked out too many details, or if it was just the sculpt, it didn't really show through. There it is. Jacket buttons. There we go. Okay. So the metal we need. Did we see anything yet on the camera? No, not too much. Next up, I'm gonna do the Black Templar contrast all over his jacket.
And his boots are also black. Set on. Have a bit of white gesso on hand. Perfect. Now let's see how he looks in the camera. Can't see a heck of a lot. That's okay. What should we do next? His dreads? Sure. I'll use Gorgoranta fur for his dreads. I'm also going to put some on the hilt of his sword, since it's supposed to be brass. See, it gives the look if I have to go over it with a metallic after. Cuff. I'm sure I paint the cuff and the jacket. And then we'll hop in over here. Here it is. Okay. Well, let's stick with black. We'll black it. Next, I'll do his pants in Astra Militarum Green. Oh, I didn't shake it up very well. Pants are reset, and then we'll put on flesh color using Gilliman flesh for flesh. We got bare chest. His little face. Coming along. Not bad. Should probably get a little black in there. And a bit of the brown creeped up. So we're back to our metallic, the chrome. Touch that up. It's that point there. So we got some gold grunt of fur. Touch it up there. Not too shabby. This looks like there could be a bit more black in there. There, darken it up. Next, I'll put some Basilicanum Gray on his gun and all over the gynoid. Except for her hair. I did look up the pronunciation of gynoid, gynoid, and it came up as both, so. Colors are almost done. Next up, I'm going to put a little bit of this Scarlet Heavy Body Wash made from the other round ink on his glasses. Oh yeah, there we go. I'll use this Process Cyan Heavy Body Wash made from a dealer rally ink on the android, or gynoid's hair. Okay. Touch up her face a little. Hopefully get it just right. Touch up the body. Way or Chrome. Probably should wash his sword a little or something. Water down some Black Templar. Streak it on the blade. Bits on his jacket. To the edge. See if I can't pop the edges of his jacket. The tops of his boots. The gray I'm using is just a mix of the gesso, a bit of the Black Templar that was left on the palette. Alright, his face. Little gesso, little Gilliman. See if there's any details to be had in there. There's supposed to be a note there. Pop the edges of the hands. Put a touch of the Gorg Runter back on where I accidentally touched on the sword. I wanted to add a third guy to this base, but I never could find anybody. I felt really fit. Thought maybe a droid or something. These two are just on their lonesome. Maybe a little command marker of some sort. I don't really have anything like that in 6mm. But as it stands, they're gonna be pretty fun on the tabletop. So I'm gonna call them done for the painting. Next up will be the basing. Alright, so off camera, I slapped a little bit of gesso on here so that the next paint layer will stick in quite nicely. And what I'm going to paint on there is a bit of my Badlands mix. Just looks like a dark hole on the camera. But inside is a much different story. It's a texture paint to help grab the next step. And just to fill it chunky bits. Just put that on there. Very nice. Feet, spread it around. Yep, definitely gonna have to put a bit of medium in there. Alright. Otherwise, pretty darn good. That looks weight. Let's see if we can adjust that. Well, it looks pretty good. Let's wash that. Grab a bit of black for the base. Grab my basing brush for the final lap. Pretty watery on my wet palette. Is that going to behave itself? No, for the most part. Very nice. Alright, next up, I'm gonna throw a little glue on. A couple of dots. A little one here. A bigger one behind. We'll take some clump foliage. Put a few bushes on there. Brush. A bit more glue, dab it around. Usually not 100% tell the coverage for this one. Try to keep it spottier. Grab a bit of this mix. This is what I aim for, a Badlands kind of coloring theme. That's okay. Oh, there we go. sprinkle a little bit on. Tap it off. Tap it in. Looks a bit all right. It's gonna be hard to see on this camera, and even my better camera, my phone, has a hard time taking pictures of these little guys. But I'll put one up on the end, right after I say bye bye.